leave of presence, but the reality was, for a long time now, he's been, you know, things have been getting slowly worse and worse, and I'm grateful today that he's actually at peace, and very grateful for all the outpouring of sympathy and love that I'm hearing from people, all the way from the President of the United States to guys on the street. I mean, he had that everyman quality, which is what I think made him such a universally beloved critic.
It was really interesting, because I mean, I never thought I would sit down and watch two guys reviewing movies, but I watched him and Gene Siskel, and I watched him and you and him, I mean, religiously, because there was something so entertaining about it, and I really trusted your guys' advice on movies, and nobody since have I really done that with. What was he like as a friend, as a colleague?
With Roger, what you saw on TV, Anderson, and what you read in his blog, or if you saw his tweets, what you saw is what you got. That was Roger. You know, he was a larger-than-life guy. He had a great passion for the movies. You mentioned how long he's been doing this. When I joined the show, he had already been a film critic for 30 years. He had already reviewed literally 10,000 movies, and he would still get excited every time the lights went down and the curtains parted in the screening room. He was always rooting for a movie to be good, but if it wasn't good, you'd know about it.
And it's also, I mean, the scope of his influence was incredibly wide. He wasn't just movies that interested him. It was politics, it was culture, and the way we communicate and tell stories.
That's absolutely true. You know, when he lost his voice, you know, now it had been almost 6 years ago, he almost found a deeper and richer voice in his writing. And I think he felt freer to write about even more subjects. He had a little bit in the past, but then he really did. And he didn't care. If you didn't want to listen to his politics, if you didn't care about his views on religion, if you didn't want to hear what he had to say about other things, that's cool. You could just, read his reviews as always. But, you know, he was just as passionate about a lot of other subjects as he was about movies.
Nearly 4 years ago, I found this blog post that he wrote, and I just want to read some of it. It said, "I know it is coming, and I do not fear it, because I believe there is nothing on the other side of death to fear. I hope to be spared as much pain as possible on the approach path. I was perfectly content before I was born, and I think of death as the same state." He did have a remarkable kind of perspective on this journey that he was on.
He did, and he wouldn't describe himself, Anderson, as a particularly religious person, although he definitely grew up Catholic, but he was certainly very spiritual, and he was very much concerned and talked and wrote a lot about the big picture. And as you mentioned in the piece there, you know, he had gone through so many operations and he had been in so much pain, yet he continued to work because he found joy in the work and he found joy in the writing, and he was brave and he was interested and engaged with the world up until the very end.